Let's review The Green Knight. Now, I've been looking forward to this and was not disappointed. It's been a while since I've seen a great fantasy movie, and the way that David Lowry captures the scale of this world and the fantastic practical effects, it was a dark Lord of the Rings vibe, and I loved it. I was worried it wouldn't live up to the hype. Hype is kind of a weird word, though, for this style of movie. It's artistic and surreal, so it's definitely not a summer movie you pop in popcorn with all your friends. Now, I love that I didn't even know this had King Arthur and Merlin in it until the movie was over. It doesn't tell you. The movie doesn't say anything. They could have leaned really hard on that for their marketing, but they didn't, and I really appreciate and respect that. It's best that they didn't. The symbolism, the five virtues of being a knight, the ending, it all hit hard. It was a great experience, and it felt very theater. I love Dev Patel so much that someone just needs to give him an Oscar already. There's more I'd love to talk about, but it involves spoilers, so I'd say overall it's a fantastic movie, with the only nitpick being to cut 15 minutes of hallucinations, because it distracts slightly from the plot point in that moment, but 4.5 out of 5 stars.